My name is Evgeny Shvarov. I'm InterSystems developer ecosystem manager. And today I want to talk with you about deployment InterSystems solutions using Google Run, Google Cloud Run. Actually, what is all this about? Often we developers find situations when we need to deploy our demo application to some site and in production, or just for demo purposes, to deploy it on some server and to let us demo it to any other developers or prospects, or maybe deploy in production. And often it is time-consuming operation which needs us to care about server, whether it is cloud or on-premises, or we need to care about domain name. We need to understand how we will provision our solution, for example, into a cloud. And so it has a set of tasks to solve. And today I want to tell you about one technology that introduces Google Cloud. It is Google Cloud Run. And this technology, it's based on Kubernetes tech, so it's a cloud technology which gives you the way to deploy Docker containers into Kubernetes cluster. And the idea here is that with this approach, if you have a working Docker container, you are able to deploy it into Kubernetes cluster just in 5 minutes with your domain name and on host. And on the host of InterSystems community, the InterSystems developer community. So as an example of this site, I will show you this demo. Like, we are on InterSystems Open Exchange. So we have like COVID-19. And we can check the demo with like COVID. Site, yes, and yes, so we can do HTTPS. So as you see, it has the structure like name, then demo.communityintersystems.com, and then the full URL of the application, and it works. It's just an IRIS BI solution. It works online. So this solution was deployed with this Google Run technology. Okay, now I suggest to go through this process with deploying an arbitrary ZPM application, for example, web terminal. So, okay, let's do that. So to make it happen, we need a template, and here on OpenExchange we have a separate template just to for these purposes. So it is called Iris Google Run Deploy Template. Okay, let's go to the repository. And actually, this is very simple repository, and the whole idea of how and why it works and how it differs from any other repositories is that in .github workflows folder we have a build push gcr google run YAML that has a trigger on master and main where we see image name, service and domain name. So if you change this to your own name, you will be able to see that deployed. If you and if also if you have this workflow file in your repository, and if you submitted it to GitHub, and because of the fact of that this file is situated in .github workflows folder, it's been automatically launched using GitHub Actions. So now we will see how it works. So let's create our own repository using this template. So I will put it in my repo. Let's name it like web. Let's deploy web terminal. Web terminal demo. Fine. So I create a repository. Okay, and I do code copy and open it in my laptop in VS Code. I suppose that you have a Visual Studio Code with InterSystems object InterSystems package installed here. And I go to the source control section and copy and paste this the name of this repository, and I place it into certain folder, in any folder actually on my laptop. So I open it. Okay, let's build it first to be sure that to make sure that it works. Okay, finally we see it's working. Let's test that it indeed works. Okay, let's find what is the name of the terminal we are looking for. So okay, we need to install the terminal, we need IRIS script file, and then here before loading the module, we will do the following set sco equal $vpn install web terminal. So we added this line and we'll rebuild it. Let's check that we will have that terminal in our changed Docker image. We see it's been installed. Okay. And let's refresh the connection because we work it in random port at the moment, so then open the management portal and try to reach the terminal. Yes, it works, so we use the standard password and login, and you see the terminal working. Great. Another thing that we need to set up is a secret key that will let GitHub actions using this workflow to reach out InterSystems Cloud project, which we use for hackathons and cost contests, and to deploy this demo project there with this domain name. So, and of course, if you wanna use this technology of deployment for your purpose, you need to set up your own project ID, cluster, GitHub, and etc. on your Google account, and then use the same approach but with your own Google service key. Okay, so the Google service key could be found in Discord. There is a Docker channel here, and if you Google for a service, if you search for service account, yes, you will find the page, the conversation here, and here is a link to a Dropbox. This link to the Dropbox will be shared with you. And you can copy this key, which could be used to deploy the solution during the contest. And then we need to go back to our repository. So to do this, we can compile remote after my demo, and we go to settings, to the secrets section, and here we add a new secret with the certain names like service account. Okay, this name is should be exactly like that, and we copy and paste what we had in this secret file and we edit. Great. And next, let's make a commit. The repository and see what will happen. Okay, we pushed it to the terminal reactions, and as you see, we have workflow running. And we are interested in this Cloud Run repo. And as we see, this change initialized some activity in it initialized. And as we see, our commit has initiated the workflow, GitHub Actions workflow, and it takes a while, about several minutes, so we can do anything else at that moment. So after a few minutes, we see that deploy to Cloud Run is successfully completed. So we can try to see if it works, and actually for that we need whatever will we try to find it. Actually we need this, and the name of the web app. Okay, standard login and password. Great. We see it's working. Perfect. So just to wrap up, you can use Google Run to deploy any Docker container to Google Cloud, Kubernetes Engine. And we in InterSystems, we've prepared Google Run template. That lets you use the template and a key to deploy any your Docker image with InterSystems IRIS into Google Cloud, into Google Kubernetes Engine using Google Cloud Run. There is some issue though here that the way how it works, if you examine the Google Run technology, it is a deployment of like the deployment is not stateful. So that means then when you stop this Docker container running, it will delete everything. So all the data you will insert during while the server works, like, so if we rerun this, if we do redeploy, for example, if we change something in our code and deploy it again, so we will initiate a new deployment, this data will disappear, it will be erased. So we will have the same Docker image again that we baked with our repository and the source code. But for demo purposes, this is a perfect. This could be a very helpful solution, as you think. Okay, so thank you for your attention and stay tuned on developer community and developer community YouTube, and create solutions with InterSystems IRIS data platform. Thank you.